It was an odd Games in the sense that, you know, as a 19-year-old, you should be, oh, I've got the Olympic Games and, you know, all the grandeur of opening ceremonies and everything that it should be. But we were wrapped up in this whole political argument.
Those who believe that sport has nothing to do with politics are living in a dream world.
Weren't even sure if the team was going to go at one point.
Neither I nor the American people would support the sending of an American team to Moscow.
A lot of other countries followed suit after America had decided they weren't going to go. And there was pressure, a lot of pressure, I think, for Great Britain to follow suit.
Mrs. Thatcher appeals again to Britain's athletes, think again about going to Moscow.
There was a concerted media campaign about whether it was the right thing or the wrong thing. And there were certain newspapers which were trying to put the BOA under a lot of pressure to change its mind. But I think as far as the BOA and the British Amateur Athletic Board were concerned at the time, it was always a case, we are going until somebody says we're not.
The overwhelming point of view from the athletes is that they want to go.
Even as a 19-year-old, you know, I was very aware of what the arguments were. But you know, it wasn't just that I wanted to go to the Olympic Games. I genuinely thought that it was the right thing to do. And I still, to this day, would have thought exactly the same today if we were in the same situation. I sort of flew into a different world. You know, communist Russia, as it was then, was very different to anything I'd experienced up to that point. Media intensity of almost intrusion, really, around Coe-Ovett in particular, was something I'd never experienced. Probably two guys in a scenario that has maybe never been repeated. I don't know if it has been to that level. So it was interesting to watch those two characters play out their roles, if you like, yet still trying to find my own way through it and try and ignore everything that was going on around those two. Well, the final was a slightly bizarre day. The village cleared out. 1500 was on the last day. I was left in the village. Steve Ovett and his coach Harry got in the lift. We go down, and Seb Corney's dad get in the lift. You know, you think, oh, this will be good, you know. And it was a little bit frosty, and, you know, some polite exchanges. And then we got down, and there was an athlete's bus, which I got on with Steve Ovett, and Seb had a car. You know, two very different approaches. I was sitting with Steve, and he seemed very preoccupied about where Seb was and why isn't Seb. You know, I kept saying to Harry, you know, where's Seb? Where's he warming up? And why isn't he warming up where we are? Going into the call-up room, the other eight of us watching Coe-Ovett kind of not speak to each other, but the body language and everything was interesting. And then walking out into the arena, and I remember thinking, wow, you know, this is what I wanted. This was the Olympic final, 80,000 people. And of course, all the cameras trained on those two, but you're just so delighted to be there. And even when I got the start line, unfortunately, I kept going, wow, this is the Olympic final, this is the Olympic final. And the gun went, and I was still going, wow, this is the Olympic final. So I was immediately last, and didn't improve on that too much during the race, to be fair.
Oh, it's in trouble! And Coe-Ovett for revenge, he wants! Hold it!
When I crossed the line, Ovett had his arm up, Seb was prostrate on the ground. I think I sort of made sort of consolation noises to Seb and went over to congratulate Ovett. And only then I turned around to see Seb getting up and realised, whoa, hold on a minute. The guy who I thought was going to win, and I think everybody thought, hadn't won. And if you're at the back of the field, sometimes you don't know who's won. It was an incredible learning experience, the whole thing for me, particularly because of what those two were going through, and it stood me in so much good stead for the rest of my career. I think had I not gone to Moscow, I might not have had some of the successes I had. So it will always actually have a good place in my athletics heart, if you like. It was an important Games for me.